Hello and welcome to Nikolay's genetics lessons. And today's question is: the length of the mtDNA is 152 nanometers. How many turns it contain? It looks like it is a very easy question. By the way, I got it from one of my subscribers. But it's not as straightforward as you may think, because the information that we can find within textbooks or on the internet may vary depending on the source of the information, the distance between two adjacent base pairs, and how many base pairs we have per one turn. For example, this table I took from the Wikipedia. By the way, here on the right we see three conformation forms of the DNA, so adDNA, bDNA, and cDNA. We see here A and B DNA would be right-handed, but cDNA would be left-handed, so would turn in different direction. And also top view, also as you see, very different. By the way, this picture is not up to the scale, just give idea, but not drawn here up to the scale. So this one is much wider than this one, for example, and much shorter than cDNA form. And I would say that bDNA form would be relaxed form of the DNA. Some people may think that relaxed form of the DNA would be two backbones that go in parallel, but actually relaxed form of the DNA would be this bDNA form. And what else? Let's pay attention to this table. We would be interested in this row. So bDNA, as you see, according to this information, has 10.5 base pairs per one turn. We also see how many, how much in angstroms we measure distance between adjacent base pairs, and also here we see in nanometers, so 3.32 angstroms and 0.332 in nanometers, because we have data here in nanometers, so let's use nanometers. So once again, per one full turn, we are given this information that one full turn is 3.32 nanometers. How we got this number? We just move this decimal point one place to the right, and here goes a mistake, because here we have 10.5, so we have to multiply this number not just by 10 but by 10.5. This is Wikipedia, and we can get a mistake here because anyone can edit it. For example, here the number calculated correctly, we just multiply 12 by 0.38 and we are going to get this number, but here we have a mistake and a mistake here. So if we multiply this number by this number, the answer have to be different. So anyway, if you would search the literature, you would find that the distance per one full turn is about 3.3 nanometers to so from 3.3 to 3.4 nanometers. So also, as you see, information is variable, so our answer also cannot be exact. And for example, take a look at this picture that I also found on the internet, and as you see here, depending on the point where we take measurements, we also can get different number. For example, here we are going to get 3.3 angstroms, and if we will take measurements here, we are going to get 3.4 angstroms. We still measure distance between two adjacent base pairs, but just in different points. So once again, this also give us variation in numbers. So usually you are not going to get such question on your exam. Usually you would get a multiple choice question with multiple choice answers that you have to choose. So basically in our today's calculations, we just have to use two numbers. So some sources would give us information that the distance between two adjacent base pairs would be 0.33 nanometers, and other sources would tell us 0.34. And of course we also have information in between, but let's take extreme range of numbers that we can find in the literature, and some would simplify and tell us that per one turn DNA has 10 base pairs. Some other sources may say 10.5 base pairs per single full turn. So in this case we are going to get, for example, 3.3 nanometers per full turn of the DNA, and here we are going to get 3.57 nanometers per full turn. So basically our answer would be just a range of numbers, and any answer that would fall in between would be the correct answer. So our minimum would be now 152 nanometers, the length of our DNA. We have to divide by 3.3 nanometers, and another variant would be 152 divided by 3.57 nanometers per one single turn. So the minimum number that we can get would be 46.06, so we can round it to 46 full turns, and if we divide 152 by 3.57, we are going to get 42.6, so we can round this number to 43. So basically if an answer would be between 43 and 46, this is going to be the correct answer. So as I said, usually on the exams you wouldn't get such a question as it is, because it's supposed to be not exact number, but with a range of numbers depending on the source of the information that you use for your calculations. So usually such questions on the exam has multiple choice answers, and you just have to choose the answer that would be between these two numbers. So any answer between these two numbers would be the correct answer. And this is all for today. Thank you for your attention. Please subscribe for my new videos that I post almost every day. Thumbs up if you like this video. Please write your comments, questions if you have any. Share this video with your classmates, and see you in the next video. Goodbye.